Okay, good morning. We are in the last part of the chapter in exponents and powers, where we are going to see how to express a given large number or a very small number in the standard form. So what do you mean by a large number and a small number? Now I'll just show you a few examples of large numbers. Suppose I have a number like this. This is a large number. Do you all agree it's a large number? Because the number of digits have been more than 3, 6, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 digits number. 14 or 15 digit number. So this is a large number. When I want to write this number every time, I don't have to write it in this form. I can write it in a short form by using exponents. That's exactly what is called as the standard form. When you want to express a very large number in a short form using the exponents, that is called the standard form of representing a large number. The same thing holds for a very small number. So what is a very small number? This is an example, like I can write this number. This, do you agree, it's a small number because it is a decimal number. And after the decimal point, you can see so many zeros are there. So again, when I want to use this number frequently, when I'm doing an addition or a subtraction, or I want to show the number on a page, I don't have to write it in this form. There is a shorter form of writing this small number using exponents. So that is called expressing a small number in the standard form. So how to express a given large number or a small number using the standard form is what we are going to learn today. But where do you come across these kinds of large numbers? Is there any place where you have realized that you have very, very big numbers? For example, if I want to measure the distance between the earth and the moon, do you think it will be a very small number that I can write like this? It will be much more bigger than this. So such numbers, every time I don't have to show all the digits to convey the meaning of the number or the size of the number. Where do you come across such small numbers? All the microorganisms that you are studying in your biology, they are not visible with our ordinary eye. Your teacher would have been telling you, you have to use some instruments to view them. Have you come across this in science? Microorganisms like a virus or a bacteria. Can you simply see the bacteria and the virus just by looking at it like this with your ordinary normal human eye?
No.
How do you think people are able to see the virus or the bacteria?
I mean microscope.
Yes, there is an instrument which is a magnifying instrument. It is magnifying or showing the image maybe 100 times larger than what the actual size is. And that's why we are able to see it. Any virus that you want to see, simply by using your normal eye, you can't see them. You have to magnify them and see because they are very small in size. So when I'm talking about the size of a microorganism or the size of a virus, those will be represented in small numbers like this. So there also, I don't have to write the size of a microorganism in this way. I can write it in a shorter manner using my exponents. So now we are going to see, how are we going to construct, this is called the usual form of the number. We are going to convert the usual form into the standard form. When does the usual form become a standard form? When we are going to express that in the form of exponents. Now we will take the large numbers first. Let us try to understand how we can represent these large numbers using the exponent. Now I'll take the same number. This is 856 followed by 3, 6, 9, 10, 11 zeros. So can I write it like this? This given number, I know it is 856 followed by 3, 6, 9, 11 zeros. So can I rewrite this like this as 856 into 1 followed by 11 zeros? Yes or no? Because if you multiply these two numbers, you will get this back. Now, why I am trying to express it in this form is, I know this 1 followed by 11 zeros can be written as 10 to the power 11. Is that correct? Because I know 10 to the power 1 is 10, 10 to the power 2 is 100, 10 to the power 3 is 1000 and so on. We know. When I say 10 cube, it means it is 10 into 10 into 10, which will be 1 followed by 3 zeros. Alright? So whenever I want to write 1000, I know it can be written as 10 cube. When I want to write 100, I know it can be written as 10 square. That is, the number of zeros will decide what is the power of 10. Alright? Now here you have 11 zeros followed by 1. Sorry, following the 1. So can I write this as 10
to the power of 11?
Yes, that's exactly what I have. 3, 6, 9. Did I leave 1? Sorry, 11. So when I have 1 followed by 11 zeros, I can write it as 10 to the power 11. So you see how I have made a short form of the large number that I have. Now when I want a standard form, always remember, you have to represent it in such a manner that you have powers of 10 with the given digits. Alright, now this also is still not in the standard form. Because in the standard form, always we will have a whole number part and a decimal part. So this number 856, I will write as 8.56. That means I should split the number as a whole number part and a decimal part. So 856 and 8.56 are not the same. Do we all agree on that? 856 and 8.56 are not the same. Yes or no?
Yes.
856, this is 8.56. So I cannot tell 856 can be directly written as 8.56. But is this allowed? Now 10 to the power 11 kaage 8.56. Here I am writing the 856 as 8.56 into 100. Idu yarnu multiply padadre idu baratha? Yes or no? 8.56 and 100 alli multiply padadre, you have to just take two jumps. No. Multiplication by 100 you have done in the 6th and 7th standard. The decimal will shift towards the right by two places because there are two zeros. So 8.56 into 100, I am getting back this original 856. So I am writing 8.56 as, sorry, 856 as 8.56 into 100. Now see how the standard form has come. ಈಗ ಇದರ 10 ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ ಏನಂತ ಬರೀತೀನಿ 10 ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ 11 ಇದೆ 10 ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ ಏನು ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ 100
10 ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ 2
ಎಸ್ 10 ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ 2 ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ 10 ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ 11
10 ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್
2 ಅಂಡ್ 11 ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಆಡೆಡ್ ಅವರ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೋನೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಬೇಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೋನೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಸೋ ದಿಸ್
10 ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ 13
ಇಂಟು 10 ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ 13 ಗುಡ್ ಸೋ ದಿಸ್ ಯೂಶುವಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ is written in the standard form now. The given number is this. Ishtu dodda barodakinta badli, I can write it in the standard form like this. Clear? Now this is the logic of writing this in the standard form. But I am going to teach you a shortcut as how to express in the standard form. So put your number illi kigide, 856 followed by some 11 zeros. So this is a whole number. Alright, so then the decimal point is there. You should imagine it like this. This point 0. The whole number. So in a standard form, this decimal should first come between the first two digits. So decimal is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So in the decimal, it will come between. ಎಷ್ಟು ಜಂಪ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದ್ರಿ ಅಂತ ಕೌಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಟೆನ್ ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ 13 ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಕಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ಟೀಚ್ ದೋ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಬಟ್ ಇದು ಪೂರ್ತಿ ಮಾಡೇ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ಬೇಕಂತಿಲ್ಲ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋ ನಂಬರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒಂದು ಹೋಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಡೆಸಿಮಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹಂಚ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಗಿವೆನ್ ಹೋಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ ದ ಡೆಸಿಮಲ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಡೆಸಿಮಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಝೀರೋ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ Only one digit in the whole number part, all the remaining should be in the decimal point. So this decimal has to go and sit between 8 and 5. In doing so, how many places did you move? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. That is why this is written as 8.56 into 10 to the power 13. You may have a small term. Ma'am, only 6 are there, some 2 more numbers are there. Yen maadbe kadanala. Yelli varge nimge numbers idyo adana varge barkondu the zeros anna avoid maadbodu. Because the exponent will take care of those zeros. Clear? So this is the way in which a usual form is put in the standard form. We will take one more example and try. Maybe when we do more, you will understand better. Till now, whatever I have said, have you understood? Have you written this down?
Yes, ma'am.
So we will take one more number. Now you should be able to tell me how to do it. Standard form Bharata example. Please artha maadkondu. Try to understand what I am trying to do. Otherwise, ask me if you have not understood. We'll take up one more problem and try to understand. Okay, the number is 405 followed by 4 zeros. Madi standard form. First 0 hero dana, you 10 to the power. Yeh dana baritira.
10 to the power of 4.
Yes, so 405 into 1 followed by 4 zeros at the baritira. So, it is 10 to the power 4 and the power, you will put it as 10 to the power 4. Then you have 405. Again, but like, what should you do here?
Ma'am,
decimal. Because here 2 digits are there. Right?
Still, people are getting added.
Huh. Then you have 10 to the power 4. So it is 4.05 into 10 square
to the power of 2.
So it is 4.05 into 10 to the power of 6. Now try it here only. This was the number given. So it is not the whole number, matte decimal part are noted. So this is the whole number part. The decimal part is 0. So this decimal has to reach between 4 and the next digit. So see how many times it is jumping. 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 4.05 into 10 to the power 6. Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Understanding?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so we'll take up one more now. Let me see. Okay, this is the number. 1496. Followed by 9 zeros. Let me see. 1496 followed by 9 zeros. But either work on the tapke hagodila. Idunu maadabodu. This is a shortcut I have taught you. You can follow any method that you feel it is easy. But always remember standard form and whole number part only one digit irbeku. Only one digit. All the remaining should come after the decimal point. So in this number, where the decimal should come? Between which two digits?
13, 12, 13.
Between 1 and 4. Come on, do it. So this can be written as 1, 4, 9, 6 into 10 to the power 3, 6, 9. So 10 to the power?
9.
Good. You know, in the standard form, Mandela. So it is now 1.496 into yen anta hakbeko 100 hakbeko
alla ma'am 1000
yes, because you have 3 digits to move ee decimal illi barbeku so 3 digits jump kali barbeku so it will be 1000 already I have 10 to the power 9 so this will be 1.496 into 10 to the power 3 into 10 to the power 9 so that will become 1.496 into
10 to the power 12.
Correct.
10 to the power of 12.
You can check here also. I told a shortcut, no? The decimal is here. This is the decimal part. This is the whole number part. The decimal should reach there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That's why you got 10 to the power 12. Understood? Will you
yes,
do one more?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let me give you one more large number. The number is 5036000. Quickly, when you do, you can see the decimal is sitting here. Straight that madana without expanding.
10 to the power of 6, ma'am.
10 to the power.
See, this is the decimal point. Illinda illi shift up by decimal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is 5.036 into 10 to the power 6. Last digit A with your numeral part, I'll give it again. 0 0 the big bit. Yes? One more will you try?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay,
yes, ma'am.
That is the number. So where is my decimal sitting? Actually, it is sitting here. From here, it has to come between 3 and 0. 1, 2, 3,
8 to the power 18.
5, 6, 7, 8. So this will become 3.0 into 10 to the power 8.
10 to the power 8.
Got it? Yes, this is the explanation of why it has become like this. This jump body count model will give shortcut gel footage in the Gotaika, is it clear?
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now last numbers we understood. Now I'm going to take small numbers.
Okay,
ma'am. What is the difference in writing it in the exponent form when you have very small numbers? Large numbers are the same. Because small numbers are the same. We'll take one small number. Okay. This is the size of a plant cell. I don't know if you know what is a plant cell. So many millimeters. This is the size for the radius of a plant cell or something like that it is given. Idanna ega exponent formally hega haakabodu. This is what you must understand. Now this is a decimal number. Do all of us agree? Because the whole number part is 0. All that is there is in the decimal part only. So e decimal number and the decimal fraction agi you should know how to convert. So this will be written as actually 7 divided by, how many digits are there after the decimal? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this will be 7 divided by 1 followed by 8 zeros. Like, suppose I have 0.7. This is a decimal number. How do I put it in the decimal fraction? It is 7 by 10. Because there is only one digit after the decimal, it is division by 10. If I had 0.07, it was 7 divided by 100.
Right.
Decimal fraction, itala neevu primary alle odidira anthe 6th or 7th odabla. Two digits after the decimal, so two zeros after one. But this should be in the denominator. In the large numbers, this exponent was in the numerator. For smaller number, the exponents are coming in the denominator. So here how will you write it? 7 into 10 to the power 1. This is 7 divided by 10 to the power 2. Correct, Alva? So when you have the exponent in the denominator and you want to take it to the numerator, what was the rule? 7 into 10 to the power negative 1. Correct, Alva? When it is positive in the denominator, it will become negative in the numerator. Or when it is negative in the numerator, it means it is positive exponent to the denominator. So like that you will write this as 7 into 10 to the power negative 2. Correct? Yesterday we have done this, no, in the laws of exponents. When you have a negative power in the 10, you can bring it to the denominator as a positive power. Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Now same way, tell me what this can be written as. 7 by 10 to the power what?
10 to the power 8.
Mom, 10 to the power 8.
So how will you put the exponent in the numerator now?
So
if it comes to the numerator, it will become negative 8. Alright? So always when you are representing small numbers in the standard form, it will have a negative exponent. This you should remember. And standard form, you should not forget to put the 7.0 into 10 to the power negative 8. Because the decimal should be between the whole number part and the decimal part. Because there are no digits after 7. We have used that 0 there. So 7.0 into 10 to the power negative 8. This is also correct. It means the same. But because standard formally avagra decimal should separate the whole number part and the decimal part, I have shown only the whole number as 7, decimal is 0 and 10 to the power negative 8. So that tell you the differences. When you are representing smaller numbers in the standard form, the exponent will be a negative exponent. Any doubt so far?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so we'll take one more small number. Let us see. If you have understood, you should be able to do. This also I will show you the shortcut. Idalla maadi illi barbodu illandre iga ee decimal alli hogbeku standard formally it should come here. Agatane you will get a whole number part. So see how many jumps you are doing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's how you are getting negative 8. Here you are moving towards the right. In the previous one you were jumping towards the left. Always remember when you have small numbers, this should be negative exponent. Because actually it is division with powers of 10. This has gone to the numerator, so it is negative 8. So, ee taranu direct aagi maadbodu. Next, we will take up one more power. Let me see. 0.000003. Do it. You will bring this to the standard form.
Ma'am, 7 into 10 to the power of 6.
Divided
10
by
to the power of minus 6.
3 divided by how many zeros are there? How many digits six. After the decimal?
6.
6 digits. So this will be 10 to the power 6.
6, uh-huh. 5.
With 3 into 10 to the power negative 6.
Negative 6, ma'am.
Or it will be 3.0 into 10 to the power negative
6.
You can count there also. See how many jumps you are doing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 3.0 into 10 to the power negative 6. Clear?
Clear, ma'am.
Yes, one more. Standard form is coming. Please remember, there is one question in 2 marks also in powers and exponents. So that 2 marks is most probably going to be your standard form. All right? See, I'm giving you so many clues for the exam. Please be very, very careful. Yeah.
Okay.
So the next number is 0. This is a tricky one. Let me see how we are doing it.
Ten to the power of 8, ma'am.
No.
10 to the power of minus 5.
No.
1.275 into 10 to the power of minus 4.
Minus 4 or minus 5? I have it out. See.
Minus 4.
Why is this problem? Minus 4. One minute. Why this is different from the previous problem? Yellanu zeros alla. Then you have some digits also. So, standard formal barbekandre, I should have only one digit before the decimal. That is, the decimal should come between 1 and 2. So, how many jumps will you do?
Ma'am, minus 5.
Then why did I write 4 here? Is that correct?
No,
no, ma'am.
Have that tendency to write 4. Because 4 0 kaanustidilla idu bariyodu samane navalla tappu maartivi nanu elli hogbeku anta first hogbeku the decimal should come between 1 and 2 so that division will be by 10 to the power 5 not with 4 so be careful that's why I was writing 4 to tell you 0 nodkondu alli 4 anta hakodilla actually this is the way it is done then this will be the next
1.275 10 to the power of minus 5.
You should reach the first non-zero digit. So illi bere yavdu illa adadmele. So nan hogbekagirodu illi. But here nan illi varige hogbekagilla because here itself I am achieving my standard 4. The first non-zero digit is 1. So nanna decimal illi bandre saaku. So I have to make only 5 jumps. So it is 10 divided, sorry, divided by 10 to the power 5, which will become 10 to the power negative 5. Innondu number kodthini nodana. Be careful, there are so many things that you have to simultaneously remember. Mari, careful ag mari. Count the number of zeros first.
Nine point 42 into 10 to the power of -11.
-11. Don't tell -11. -11. He is telling -11. Is it correct? Let us check. Illi iro decimal ellu hogbeku. 9.42 agbeka. 94.2 agbeka.
9.42.
It should come between 9 and 4. So see,
yes,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So this will be written as 9.42 into 10 to the power, divided by 10 to the power 11. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear, ma'am.
Good. Any doubts so far?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
This will come for 2 marks children. Okay? No, it can be given as a large number, convert it into standard form, or a small number, convert it into standard form. Do you think you'll be able to score?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then I think you please look at page number 200 in your textbook. Exercise 12.2. There are some problems there which you can do. Many of the problems I have taken and worked out already. The remaining you can do it as a practice for yourself. All right?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, I think you should be able to do. So that completes our syllabus for our exams which will start on the 20th of March. I hope you got your timetable.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. When is our max exam?
I'm 24.
24. So we must get ready for the exam. We have to do a little revision because some of the chapters we have done somewhere in the month of October, September, etc. So quickly the remaining days that we are meeting, we will do revision. Factorization, sir, will start tomorrow and he will take Saturday, Monday and Tuesday. I think in 3 days, whatever we can do for factorization, he would do. When we are taking up the revision, I will try to focus on that factorization also. So next class I am meeting you on Wednesday.
Okay.
When shall we start? You tell me from which chapter we can start the revision. Which one has got the maximum weightage? We will start from there.
Mom, linear
equation. The mensuration.
Linear equations. What is the weightage given for linear equations? Okay. No problem. We can start with linear equations. Nothing to worry. But what is the marks given for linear equation? Can you quickly look at it and tell me?
Ma'am, 2 marks, 1 question.